The Morrison government is slowly losing its bid to impose random drug tests on welfare recipients after Crossbench Senator Jacqui Lambie raised new concerns about the lack of rehabilitation services linked to the plan. Labor used the first sitting day back after a five-week hiatus to target the government on the state of the economy.
After a long winter break, parliamentarians are back in the capital.
Isn't this lovely, hey?
The opposition running towards their target, wasting no time in attacking the government on the state of the economy.
Can the Treasurer confirm that the Australian economy is growing substantially slower than forecast in his budget just 5 months ago?
When it comes to nominal GDP, it is growing above the budget forecast. Above the budget forecast.
The member for Rankin.
5.3%.
But the first sitting day back was dominated by a senator from outside of the major parties.
I've had the most pleasant 8 weeks without you people, I've got to be honest with you.
Power broker Jacqui Lambie likely holds the key vote on two pieces of welfare legislation, putting conditions on her support to drug test Newstart recipients.
I won't be supporting it, and I won't be supporting it unless the services are there and I can see the rehab services and the services that these people need to kick their habit.
Doubling down on calls for the government to lead by example.
You do not inflict on others what you won't do to yourself. It's as simple as that.
Yeah, I don't think you should vote if you're wide. I really don't.
Yeah, knock yourself out. Why not? I've got nothing to hide.
The government also wants to expand its cashless debit card, a move Senator Lambie supports. It quarantines 80% of a welfare recipient's payment so it cannot be spent on alcohol or gambling.
It makes people's lives harder. It does not help them.
The integrity of federal MPs is also on the agenda after Labor and the Crossbench backed a bill to introduce a national anti-corruption watchdog in the Senate, piling pressure on the coalition.
If you vote against this, the Australian public will ask, what are you trying to hide?
With the government's majority in the House of Representatives, it's unlikely to go further.
It might seem like the Greens are using this bill as nothing more than yet another cheap shot at the government.
The government has pledged to create an integrity commissioner, but for Labor and the Crossbench, their proposal doesn't go far enough. Nikari Thorpe, SBS World News.